In this video, we will explain how to install the enterprise version of LiteSpeed Web Server on the Plesk Obsidian WebOps hosting platform. Before we begin, you will need to have a cloud-hosted VPS installed and configured with the Plesk control panel and a working copy of Apache HTTP server. You will also need a fully qualified domain name pointing to the Plesk server. And lastly, you'll need to open the following ports at the server level and at the Plesk firewall: 22 for SSH, 7088, 80, and 443 for TCP, and 443 for UDP. Once these prerequisites are dealt with, we can dive into the following topics: disabling the Nginx reverse proxy, checking the PHP handler configuration, obtaining a LiteSpeed Enterprise license, installing LiteSpeed Web Server, and verifying that LiteSpeed Web Server is running. First up, we must disable the Nginx reverse proxy. Plesk Obsidian ships with Nginx configured as a reverse proxy that sits between Apache and the internet. To prevent this setup from interfering with LiteSpeed configuration, it needs to be disabled. Sign into Plesk, then navigate to Tools and Settings, then Server Management, then Services Management, and press the Stop button next to Reverse Proxy Server Nginx. Apache should now be running alone with Nginx. If you'd like to verify that Apache is listening on HTTP port 80 and HTTPS port 443, you can run the lsof command, which is listed in the video description. The next step is to verify that you have Fast CGI application enabled. Navigate to Tools and Settings, then General Settings, then PHP Settings. You'll see a list of available PHP handlers. Flick the switch to enable any of the Fast CGI application handlers that you want enabled. Now you're ready to install LiteSpeed Web Server. Obtaining a license is just optional. It is possible to complete all of the steps in this video with a simple 15-day trial license. Just be aware that once the trial period is over, you'll need to purchase a license if you want to continue to use LiteSpeed Web Server. If you need help choosing an appropriate license, see the link in the description. If you would like to use a trial license, you can skip ahead to the next section of the video. To purchase a LiteSpeed Web Server license, visit store.lightspeedtech.com in your browser, choose the license that you would like to purchase and click Order Now, choose a billing cycle, select a caching product, and click Continue. If you're not sure what type of caching you need, choose LS Cache Standard, which is included for free in every license. Click Checkout, enter your personal or company details, select a payment method, and click Complete Order. If you don't have a LiteSpeed account, you will create one during the checkout. An invoice for your purchase will be sent to your email address. This invoice will include license details, but you may also find the serial number on your account homepage. Look in the Your Active Product/Services section where it says Serial. Copy this to your clipboard, since you'll need it for the next step. Installing LiteSpeed Web Server. There are two ways to install LiteSpeed Web Server in a Plesk environment. You can download the LiteSpeed Plesk extension and use that, or you can install from the command line. We'll show you both methods, and you can choose whichever one you prefer. Method 1, the LiteSpeed Plesk extension. LiteSpeed has developed an extension for Plesk which is meant to help you with server management and cache management tasks. You can also use the extension to install LiteSpeed Web Server. You can download the LiteSpeed extension from our website using the link in the video description, or you can download it and install it from within Plesk itself. Navigate to Extensions, and use the search box to find the LiteSpeed extension. Click Install LiteSpeed Extension, and click Get It Free. Once the plugin is installed, you can use it to install the LiteSpeed Web Server. Click Open, and then Install LiteSpeed Web Server, read the LiteSpeed License Agreement, and click I Agree. If you purchased a LiteSpeed Enterprise license, click Use an Enterprise license and type in the serial number. Otherwise, click Request a Trial License. If you're going to want the ability to test LiteSpeed Web Server while Apache is still running, you can use a port offset for LiteSpeed. We recommend this so that you may test your LiteSpeed setup without experiencing any downtime. Just be aware that if you use these additional ports, you will need to open them at your firewall. To use a port offset, navigate to Installation Options and set Port Offset to 1000. This will tell LiteSpeed to listen for HTTP connections on port 1080 and HTTPS connections on port 1443, and will allow you to have both LiteSpeed and Apache running at the same time. Type in a username and password for Web Admin Console Login. In the Additional Setup section, select Open LiteSpeed Web Admin Firewall Port, open HTTP/3, Quick, Connection Firewall Port, and Set Server/VH Cache Routes. Click Install to start the software installation. When the installation is complete, click Restart LiteSpeed to start the web server. You can continue configuring LiteSpeed Web Server through the LiteSpeed plugin if you'd like. You can set the cache route, switch between LiteSpeed and Apache, manage cache plugin installations across your server, and more. We won't go into too much detail on that here, but we've made a video that explains everything. Check the description for a link. Method 2, the command line interface. If you don't want to use the LiteSpeed extension, you can install LiteSpeed Web Server from the command line. Connect to your Plesk environment via SSH, and run the get.lightspeed.sh installation script. You can either provide your license serial number or type out the word trial to start a 15-day trial period. We've put the exact commands in the video description in case you'd like to copy them. The installation script will begin by prompting you to answer a few questions. We're not using an options file, so type Y and press Enter to proceed. On the enable php underscore suexec prompt, enter 2 to enable php underscore suexec and press Enter. Set the port offset to 1000 and press Enter. Provide an administrator username and email address, then enter 0 to inform the installer that you do not wish to switch PHP handlers. Finally, the script will ask whether to switch to LiteSpeed Web Server when the installation completes. Since we have set a port offset, we can run LiteSpeed and Apache at the same time while we test LiteSpeed Web Server. Enter 0 at the prompt. When all responses to each prompt have been provided, installation will proceed. When it completes, you will see a success message that includes a randomly generated password for the LiteSpeed web admin console. Please save this password in a safe place. Verifying LiteSpeed is running. Now that we've successfully installed LiteSpeed Web Server, let's verify that it's running. In the Plesk control panel, click Process List. This will display a paginated list of running processes. You should see at least one row for LiteSpeed. Click the word LiteSpeed to see more information about the running process, including the process ID and statistics for resource usage. At this point, LiteSpeed is installed and running alongside Apache on a port offset. Take this opportunity to test your configuration. Install the LiteSpeed plugin if you haven't already, and use it to configure caching across your server. When everything is configured to your liking, you can use the plugin to switch to LiteSpeed Web Server full-time. Congratulations! You've successfully installed LiteSpeed Enterprise in a Plesk environment. If you face any issues with your setup, please see the links in the description for troubleshooting and more. Or open a support ticket from your client area. We're happy to help. Thank you for liking, sharing, and subscribing. See you soon!